Business records are generally about how the business was run and the trade in which it was engaged. They may also be used for wider research into local, social, product and design history. They can provide legal evidence or inspiration for new works. The world of business is very varied, from the pillow lace account books kept by Rachel Reed of Cranfield to the complex production records of W.H. Allen of Bedford. Records can be an important asset and as such may remain with the company or be sold off to other companies. However, the importance of most records is likely to diminish as the business changes, relocates or closes. It is often at this point that the records are offered to an archive service. Sometimes, by the time they come to an archive service, they have been moved around or stored for many years, and they may not be as complete or as coherent as the archivist or the researcher would like. The types of record will depend on the sort of business and how it was run. There may be minute books, financial records and accounts, product research and development records, manufacturing records, order books. There may be photographs of products, advertising and promotional material. There may be plans and photographs of premises. The material may contain records of former or associated businesses. Mergers and takeovers or changes in direction can add to the complex picture. For example, Cutler Hammer records include the records of the Adam Manufacturing Company that used to make motor cars. And Hayward Tyler, the pump manufacturer of Luton, includes their former business making aerated bread machines. Some business records contain information on other trades, and this is particularly true of solicitors' archives. The records of Hooper and Fletcher include some papers of Dan Auburn's cycle and machinery business. Builders and architects are another example where records of one business shed light on another. T&E Neville, Manning and Steele, Franklin, Deacon and Briars, all of Luton, contain many plans of other Luton businesses in the 20th century. The records of Richardson and Hoof include business premises as far afield as office blocks in London and a distillery in Scotland. There are less obvious sources of business records. The records of customers or potential customers may contain receipted bills or catalogues. Under an Act of 1824, the bankruptcy commissioners could travel about, and some records of local retailers who went bankrupt in the 1820s to 1840s are consequently to be found among the quarter session papers of insolvent debtors. Other useful sources are rating and valuation or local authority records, and directories can also be useful. The survival rate of business records is generally poor. Even where there is a substantial amount, one thing is unlikely to be included, and that is a comprehensive record of employees. The best records for employees are often the company in-house magazines. These may record appointments, promotions and retirements, or celebrate success within the company. But they're also likely to tell us about aspects of the social life that large businesses established around them, such as the various sports teams. You may even find pieces about a particular person's hobbies or announcements of births, marriages, and deaths. Large companies, particularly the larger engineering companies, often had links across the world. Visits to and from other companies, trainees, apprentices, or employees may be recorded. Business deals and installations in other countries may be explained with a certain amount of pride for the success that they brought to the company and the work and wealth they provided to Britain. Many employees relocated to Bedfordshire from Europe, Asia, Africa and the Caribbean to help with the labour shortage in Britain, particularly after 1945. Sadly, this cultural diversity does not often show in the official company records, which rarely include details of employees. There have been efforts made to capture more information on the experience of employees through oral history projects, and Bedfordshire Archives holds a number of collections resulting from these projects.